This video is based on constraint answering optimization problems. Here we have three different constraint answering optimization problems, and we will use different optimization algorithms to find out the optimal solution for the each problem. After that, we will compare the results that we will obtain for the each problem, and then we will select the best algorithm that will provide us the better solution among all in the minimum ablutions. And then we have code. First algorithm, as you can see here, we have sparrow search optimization algorithm, and we apply this algorithm on the three different problems. First problem is belted beam design problem, second is spring reducer design optimization problem, and the last one is spring design optimization problem. Here you can see we have different problems. It means we have different objective function for each problem, we have different design variables for each problem, and we have different constraints for each problem. So we will not use the same objective function or design variables or constraint for each. We have different cost function, different decision variables, and different constraints for each. And here no parameter optimization is done, so we will apply the constraints directly on the problem. It means constraints are directly handled. So if you got any solution that is not satisfying the constraints, it means that is infeasible solution. So we will consider that solution infeasible and we will abandon that solution. And if we got the solution that is satisfying the constraints, we will accept the solution and consider it feasible solution. And after that, we will compare the results that we will obtain for each problem for sparrow search optimization algorithm with PSO, GWO, and TLBO. First problem, you can see here we have belted beam design optimization problem. Here our aim is to minimize the cost of a belted beam. So we have to design a belted beam for the minimum cost, and you can see we have different constraints. This is the objective function, and here we have different constraints. For this problem, here we have four continuous decision variables, or you can say design variables. And here we have seven constraints. You can see here we have seven constraints, two linear and five non-linear. And we have to satisfy all these constraints. Here you can see this is the beam A that is holded by belt B. And you can see the decision variables x1, x2, x3. And you can see we have different constraints like shear stress, bending stress, and so on. So we have to satisfy all these constraints for this problem. So if the solution that we obtain is satisfying all these constraints, then we will consider the solution feasible, else infeasible. For the second problem, that is speed reducer design optimization problem, our aim is here the design of the speed reducer is to be minimized. And here we have seven decision variables and 11 constraints, and we have to satisfy all these constraints. If all these constraints are satisfied, we will consider the solution feasible, else infeasible. For the third problem, we have to minimize the weight of a compression spring. In this problem, we have three decision variables x1, x2, x3, as you can see here, and we have four constraints, and we have to satisfy all these constraints. And if all the constraints are satisfied, then we will consider the solution feasible, else infeasible. Here you can see we compared the results. For the comparison, we used particle swarm, Gray-Wolf teaching learning based optimization algorithm. So we will compare the results for SSA with all three algorithms. As we discussed before, that we are handling the constraints directly, we are not using any parameter optimization. So each time when you will run the code, you will get the feasible solution and infeasible solution. And this is the disadvantage that will lead to infinite number of successive trials. So in order to obtain the optimal solution, we have to make the infinite number of trials. So in order to avoid that problem, what we will do, we will make the independent run for each problem, and here we will change the number of iterations, and then we will note down the best and the worst value for the each problem. Here the best value is the minimum value and the worst value is the maximum value, and then we will calculate the fitness function evolution for each algorithm. And we can calculate the fitness function evolution by multiplying the population size with the maximum number of iteration. For the first problem, you can see here the optimal value that we obtained is this one, and we obtained this value for spell search algorithm in 30 evolutions, and for this algorithm for GWO in 132 evolutions, and for PSO 360 evolution, and for TLBO we got the value in 30 evolutions. Here you can see the burst value for each algorithm that we obtained here, and you can see among all the minimum is this one. So we can consider here the better performance is given by Sparrow Search and TLBO, as we obtained the optimal solution in the minimum number of evolutions. As you can see here, for these two algorithms, we got the maximum number of evolutions, and we will consider the minimum as the best. And here you can see among all, the minimum burst value is again for the Sparrow Search optimization algorithm. So we can consider this as best for the first problem. Now for swarm size 6, problem 2, we got the optimal value, this one, and you can see the number of evolutions they may be made, and you can see the burst value for each algorithm. And for the third problem, you can see the optimal value we obtained here, and the number of evolutions we made for each problem, and minimum number of evolutions it means. And you can see here among all, TLBO and SSA provide the optimum value in the minimum number of evolutions, and here we have no burst value for the TLBO, and you can see the minimum burst value is this one. And for the swarm size 10, we got the minimum value. Now what we did, we changed the swarm size or the population size in the main file, and you can see the output here for the first problem, for the second problem, and for the third problem. As you can see here, these two algorithms are providing the best solution in the minimum evolutions, and here you can see we have the minimum burst value only for this algorithm. And then you can see for the second problem, we have no burst value for SSA and TLBO, and we got the optimal solution in the minimum number of evolutions. And for the third problem, we got no burst value for SSA, and we got the optimum value for this algorithm in minimum number of evolutions. And you can see here we have the best solution vector for each problem for Sparrow Search algorithm. As you can see here, we have values for all the decision variables and constraints. You can see value for x1 should be greater than or equal to 0.1, and we got the value for x1 0.125. it means this value is satisfied. This value is satisfying the constraint. And for the x2, we got the value that is 0.1, and you can see this is also satisfied. For the x3, value should be less than 10, and this is also satisfied. For the x4, value should be less than 2, and this is also satisfied. For the second problem, you can see we satisfy all the constraints. And again, for the third problem, you can see x1, x2, x3. You can check the values here. All the values. We got all the values that satisfy these constraints. For the code, now here, for the simplicity, you will download all these files in the separate folder for easy testing. And we will change the parameter. As you can see, we have different problems and we have different parameters, cost function and constraints for each problem. So what we will do, we will change the parameters for each problem. And here we have parameter settings same for SSA and GWO and TLBO and PSO. You can check in the help file, and in the main file we will change the parameters for each problem. So that's all about this video. We used here different constraint engineering design problems, and we used various optimization methods to solve all these problems. And you can see here the comparison and the results, and on the basis of the evolutions you can select which one is better, that is providing the optimal solution in the minimum number of evolutions. So that's all about this video. If you have any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.